I have done men good service, but no ill turns. The elephant lives a century, the red spider a day. In power, intellect, and dignity, the one creature is separated from the other by a distance which is simply astronomical. Yet in these, as in all qualities, man is immeasurably further below me than is the wee spider below the elephant. Man's mind clumsily and tediously and laboriously patches little trivialities together and gets a result, such as it is. My mind creates. Do you get the force of that? Creates anything it desires, and in a moment. Creates without material. Creates fluids, solids, colors, anything, everything, out of the airy nothing which is called thought. A man imagines a silk thread, imagines a machine to make it, imagines a picture, then by weeks of labor embroiders it on canvas with the thread. I think the whole thing, and in a moment it is before you, created. I think a poem, music, the record of a game of chess, anything, and it is there. This is the immortal mind. Nothing is beyond its reach. Nothing can obstruct my vision. The rocks are transparent to me, and darkness is daylight. I do not need to open a book. I take the whole of its contents into my mind at a single glance, through the cover, and in a million years I could not forget a single word of it, or its place in the volume. Nothing goes on in the skull of man, bird, fish, insect, or other creature which can be hidden from me. I pierce the learned man's brain with a single glance, and the treasures which cost him 80 years to accumulate are mine. He can forget,